session. During the executive session, there was no votes or decisions made. Okay, at this time, we're going to continue on the item to employ the superintendent for the coming year. And the floor is open for a motion.
This time, I would move to employ Jeffrey Kelly as the next superintendent of Lincoln County Schools for a 3-year term beginning July 1, 2020, ending June 30, 2023, at an annual salary of $115,000 in year one, $117,500 in year two, and $120,000 in year three.
Okay. Mr. Baker has made a motion to employ Jeffrey Kelly as superintendent of Lincoln County Schools for a 3-year term beginning July the 1st, 2020, and ending June 30th, 2023, at an annual salary of $115,000 in year one, $117,500 in year two, and $120,000 in year three. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Mrs. Smith has seconded that motion. So Mr. Baker made the motion, Mrs. Smith the second. The vote is now on the floor for a board vote. Mr. Wilkerson?
Yes.
Mr. Curry?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Baker?
Yes.
And I vote yes. It's a unanimous vote, all five are yes. So Mr. Kelly will be the new Lincoln County Superintendent effective July the 1st. Any more questions or thing about the appointment of the superintendent? Mr. Mekia, what we will want to do is plan to place Mr. Kelly's contract on the May the 26th board agenda for approval. Okay, that being done, let's go to the finance section, please. Do I have a motion to look at those items?
I'll move.
Mr. Curry. Mr. Curry made the motion. Mr. Wilkerson seconded that. Mr. Mekia, if you want to handle those.
Yeah, Mr. Ellis is not with us this evening. He will be here next Tuesday as the budget for 2021 is time for it to be approved by the board. So he'll be here next week to present that budget to you.
Okay.
Item A is a schedule of invoices totaling $515,554.30. Invoices are available for review here at the office. Item B, a county pension for the following retired employees paid from excess levy funds. You may recognize that.
I just want to say that first one there. Is that accurate?
That's accurate.
Okay, so we had the payment of our invoice bills and some county pension selections there. Is that an all yes vote on those items?
Yes.
Okay, let's go to the personnel section then, please. Do I have a motion to look at those items?
I'll move.
Ms. Smith?
Second.
Mr. Wilkerson seconded that. Mr. Mekia?
Okay, item A, employment of short long-term substitute professional personnel. Item B, employment of substitute service personnel. Item C, leave of absence. At the bottom of the personnel schedule, we're requesting that we abolish service personnel posting SHR 21-01, Secretary 2, 3, Hearts PK 8. We incorrectly posted that position, indicating that the successful applicant would have to take and pass the custodian's test. Clearly an error, so we are going to repost that position tomorrow. The second one is abolishing professional personnel posting, PGV 20-49, principal, Guy Valley Middle School, 6-8. The posting was incorrect and had the wrong school year. Instead of 2021, it was posted as 1920. We'll post that position tomorrow as well, repost it. I can tell you that To date, we have three applicants for the principalship at Guy Valley, two in county, one out of county. Interviews will take place for that position June the 4th and 5th, if necessary, if we need 2 days, with a recommendation to the board at the June 16th meeting.
Okay, Mr. Meekin, now, are you reposting the Guy and Valley position?
Both, yes.
And when will that?
It'll be up for 5 more days.
Okay.
So it's been posted since May the 8th.
So that post will come down before the date you said you want to recommend, right?
Okay.
All right. I noticed you're running this section too.
I am.
All right, that's the personnel schedule being presented. Is that an all yes vote on that?
Yes.
Okay. All yes on the personnel schedule too. Okay, that brings us down to board members' comments, concerns. Any board members have anything to discuss this evening? Okay, Mr. Meekin, do you have anything for us?
I do. I've got a few items here. The CARES Act fund that I've shared with you in previous meetings, it's an additional round of money, federal programs money, that we'll be using to purchase laptops for our students in grades 6 through 12 for next year. And Mrs. Erling is working on bids for that now. I know she worked on it most of the day today. We received our preliminary allocation for that funding, and it's based on fiscal year 19's allocation, which is greater than this current year's allocation, which, if I understand this correctly, we could get up to $3,000 more in funding than what we were anticipating. So we're looking into the possibility of including students in grades 3, 4, and 5 with laptops. Now, we won't have that pinned down until around the 1st of June, so that's when we'll know for sure what that allocations look, what's going to look like. But we are hopeful that we'll be able to go down as far as the 3rd grade.
Now, that's for all students?
All students.
4 through 12.
It's over 2,000 laptops. Now, Mrs. Erling showed me one today. It's a nice laptop. It's sturdy. I think I said earlier, it's like an industrial type, you know, laptop. So it's exciting.
It's great.
I talked to a gentleman from AEP right before the board meeting this evening. He has secured funding to provide the equipment that we would need to set up Wi-Fi hotspots in all 8 of our schools. We'll be working on that over the next few weeks to get it in place in time for next school year. I have placed at your tables a draft board meeting schedule for next year. It's for you to look at, and then you can provide me or Susie feedback if there's anything in here that you may want to change, or maybe there's something in here is incorrect. Susie and I both looked at it several times. I will note that the first meeting, July the 6th, is on a Monday. Mr. Priestley may speak to that. I know in code that the first Monday after biennial election is when the board meets. So Monday, July 6th, will be the first board meeting for the new fiscal year. And the other date of note is November the 5th, that's a Thursday. And the reason that we selected that date was because the November 3rd is the general election. So that, you know, if you want to change that date, just, you know, let me know. We can move it elsewhere. CEFP. Since we last met, I spoke to Dave Ferguson about the board's desire for us to look at foregoing those last three board's desire. Talking to Dave Ferguson, I shared with you that he indicated that because of what's happened with the coronavirus and the inability to hold those community meetings, that we forego those last three meetings and instead place an ad in the Lincoln Journal that would outline what the CEFP committee has prioritized as projects or needs for the school system over the next 10 years, asking for public comment. And he is working on getting something together. So I'll let you know when that's ready. He did reiterate to me that the timelines are being extended by the SBA to complete the CEFP, although those dates have not been established. So once I know more information regarding that process, I'll let you know.
Will it be put on the website too?
Yes.
Make a comment on the website.
The bleacher installation at Hamlin, I stopped up there today, and it's beautiful floor. I'm guessing it's probably the same wood that they've used on the gym floor kind of out. It's really pretty. They were sanding it today, just doing some of the refinishing work. But out of my window be out there. I didn't get a chance to talk to Greg today, but I just wanted you to know that work is ongoing and they've made considerable progress. Mr. Gosling had shared with me a couple of weeks ago that we'd gotten some news from the bleacher company. It's located in the state of Michigan. And the governor there had shut down a lot of the businesses and companies as a result of what's going on with the coronavirus. And he was told that it could have possibly be October sometime before we get our bleachers as a result of what was going on. But that has now changed. We've gotten some good news. That company's back to work. They've indicated to Mr. Gosney that they believe that by September 1, everything will be installed and ready to go. So just wanted to let you know that's worth moving on. And speaking of gymnasiums, our governor, on Monday, has opened up fitness centers, gymnasiums, health clubs, and recreation centers on a limited basis. And these are business-related groups. We've got a letter from the state superintendent of schools, a memorandum, indicating that the guidance from the governor does not include school buildings and facilities, including our gymnasiums and weight room facilities, as they remain closed. The department will provide resources that will inform and guide county school districts into the reentry of the school buildings when public health officials determine it is safe to lower social distancing measures. Our facilities will still remain closed until we get further guidance from the department. I think there's lots of requests or questions about our gyms and our ball fields.
Is that true also, Jeff, of our playgrounds?
All of our facilities, all the board's property. No students. And let's see, finally, keeping with athletics, in case you don't know, Lincoln County's 3-week coaching window has been chosen, and it's going to be July the 6th through the 25th. And it appears that all the surrounding counties have chosen that same 3-week window. And we'll just have to wait and see as we get closer to that date of July 6th, whether or not our coaches are going to be able to have contact with our student athletes.
All right, Mr. Midkiff completed those. All right, if there's nothing else anybody from the board has, next we have one item we must do, and that involves the superintendent's evaluation. We're in the next phase of that. As everybody will recall, back in September, we established the goals for the superintendent for this year. board meeting schedule reflected that tonight we will listen to Mr. Midkiff's presentation. That'll be done in executive session as required. And he will tell us his accomplishments and how he went and scored as far as those, his goals are. And then at a meeting here at the end of June, we will then grade him on how we thought he scored on it. So, that being said, the board will go into executive session for the final time this evening. That'll be our last act of business. Listen to Mr. Midkiff's presentation, and then we will adjourn for the evening.
And then we're going to tell Sean how we evaluate him.
That's right.
And he's going to put it in the paper.
Probably going to be pretty harsh.
Yeah.
Okay, so I need a motion, please, to go into executive session for the superintendent's presentations and evaluation goals. Mr. Wilkerson made a motion. Mr. Curry seconded that. It's at 7:13 p.m. Is that an all yes?
Yes.
Okay, the board's in executive session. Thank you, everyone.